Oh, hi. Isn't fire amazing? Did you know that fire behavior is driven by the weather? Yeah, that's right. So in order to really understand fire behavior, we need to know more about the weather. Let's take a closer look.
This video will answer these questions. What is the weather? What are the elements of the weather that impact fire the most? How do those elements impact fire behavior? How do the weather elements align with the other portions of the fire behavior triangle? How can fire weather inform situational awareness and decision-making? There is a lot to the weather, and this video will just touch on some of the basic principles, so make sure to tune in to the other videos on weather, fire behavior, and fuels in this series. Fire behavior is influenced by fuels, weather, and topography. Can you guess which of those elements changes the most and is the hardest to predict? If you guessed weather, you'd be right. Take a second and turn to the fire environment assessment process in the Incident Response Pocket Guide, if you have one. The fire assessment process and other resources, like the fire environment poster, are meant to help you notice when you might experience the next big change in fire behavior. A big part of the process for noticing potential changes in fire behavior is noticing changes in the weather. The weather is the state of the atmosphere, how hot, dry, and windy it is. There are a lot of variables to consider when thinking about the weather, but at the basic level, when thinking about fire behavior, we're considering a few elements that are usually measured at a remote automated weather station, or ROS. These elements include temperature and relative humidity, solar radiation, precipitation, and wind. Each of these variables influence fire behavior in a variety of ways, but for now, let's break them down into two main categories, moisture and movement, and their impacts on fire behavior. Temperature, relative humidity, solar radiation, and precipitation all affect the moisture of the fuel, which affects the intensity of the fire. The hotter, drier, and sunnier it is, the drier the fuels, and the hotter the fire. Differences in air pressure cause movement of the air. We call the horizontal movement of the air the wind, while vertical motion in the air is dependent upon atmospheric stability. The wind dictates the rate and direction of fire spread, while stability impacts how well the column rises. When the atmosphere is unstable, air can move up quickly. As air moves up quickly, more air moves over to replace it, and you have wind. The faster the wind, the faster the fire spread. When the direction of the wind changes, the direction of the fire changes. Each of these elements by themselves might not have a huge impact on fire behavior, but what happens when you get hot and dry and windy conditions all at the same time? Or what if you have those conditions and you have a steep slope and heavy fuels? Well, that's called alignment. Alignment. Like things all go in a line. This is really important because if conditions align and you are on the downwind side of that alignment, you could be in real trouble. Now, you would never get in the way of a fast-moving fire like this on purpose, of course, but why do people still find themselves downwind of moving fire? Well, something changed in the fire environment that went unnoticed. As I said at the beginning, weather is a part of the fire behavior triangle, and changes the fastest. So to foresee changes in the fire behavior, we need to anticipate changes in the weather. Don't worry, you don't need to run off and get a degree in meteorology to anticipate how the weather will change. Although if you're into that, then go right ahead. You can start anticipating changes in the weather right now by using your awareness of your situation. Go ahead, give it a try. Look outside or at the weather forecast and look at how the conditions are changing. Is it getting hotter or colder? More windy or less windy? Take a hike and watch how the winds change from one drainage to the next. Notice how the temperature changes when the sun goes behind a cloud, or how the moisture in the fuel changes when you go from a north aspect to a south aspect. Better yet, if you find yourself on a fire, watch how the different weather variables affect the fire behavior, and try to make some predictions of how the fire behavior will change as the fuels, weather, and topography change. Noticing a potential change in the weather is all well and good, but it needs to be followed up by clear communication and good decision-making. Weather reading and decision-making is best done as a team sport, so make sure to talk through any changes you're noticing that could lead to changes in the fire behavior. To review, The changes in the moisture and movement of the weather create changes in fire behavior, and the elements of the fire behavior triangle can come into alignment to create more changes in fire behavior. To anticipate those changes, turn on your situational awareness, watch for patterns in the weather, on and off the fire line, and communicate those changes. All of these steps are part of the fire environment assessment process in the IRPG.
Fire behavior is a product of weather, and the more we can understand how weather works, the more we can understand what to expect for fire behavior.